Hello, brothers and sisters in Christ. I have an older message to play for you because it's a Julie Wedby message, but it's from back in 2017. Forgive my memory. Okay, this channel called Praise Jesus, King and Savior, must have found it and reshared it. It's called Vision of the Transformation of the Bride. So it is pertinent for today, y'all, and it's very exciting. So I'm going to cover up the screen so you won't look at me and just listen. I want you to just listen to this beautiful message and then I'll finish off. Okay? All right. I'm going to cover this up. Okay. Maybe that'll stay. All right.
Okay, family. I have a message from our sister Julie Wedby from IamCallingYouNow.blogspot.com. Vision of the Transformation of the Bride. On the night of June 24th, after communion, during prayer, I was shown a vision. I was at the throne before Yahushua, along with all members of the bride worldwide. We were face down and on our knees in adoration and humility, dressed for battle and spiritually armed. In the spirit, there was the call sent forth by Yahushua, a spiritual shofar or trumpet call that went forth, drawing us collectively to attention before him. Yahushua was in full white, gold, and red battle attire, holding a scepter and with a glorious crown. He is the King of Kings. He was very powerful and mighty in his appearance. He was stoic and quite serious. It seemed several minutes of our time went by while we were in his soaking presence. He then spoke to us, "Beloved, rise." In one motion, the bride as a whole stood before him. There were people of every race, age, walk of life, and culture that we know here on earth. He spoke again to us, "There is no more time. Your journeys as you have known them are coming to an end. All will be fulfilled. For most of you, the paths you have walked have been extremely difficult. You are my chosen because you have prevailed through it all, holding fast to my promises, trusting me, and praying for continued faith to move forward. I understand all you have been through. But I know your hearts. I chose you and I love you. I know each heart and I know you love me. They hated me much more than they hate you. They persecuted me more than you have been persecuted. You are presented here to fulfill your final tasks." While he was speaking, I was shown in the spirit all at once each person's obstacles, distractions, stumbling blocks, attacks of the enemy, betrayals, etc. The tests and trials are refining for each one. Everything that took place over the course of each one's life. I saw the dark cloud of the enemy and how hard he worked to keep each chosen one from their purpose, from their relationship that Father had created intimately for each one. I saw the discouragement, the resistance, doubt, fear, hopelessness at times, frustration and weakness as each one continued on the path to holiness for his name's sake, following the extremely narrow the lighted path towards Yahushua. Eyes always focused on our Savior. I saw all those who had persevered, even when curses and spells had been prayed against them, although the darkness around and coming at each one was intense to say the least. The path was protected and impenetrable for those who chose to walk on it. A pinpoint of light, it seemed, amongst such gross darkness. Yahushua then paused again for some time before he spoke again. "All you who are the forgotten, the lowly, the outcast, the homeless, the poor, those that this world threw away, those who were nobody on the earth, come forward." There was a small group that was suddenly directed in front of Yahushua. "This world may not have cared for your existence of who you are and may have forgotten you, but you will never be forgotten here. Well done, my faithful ones. Welcome home." This small group turned around towards the rest of us, because they are the humblest of all, not wanting to leave until they knew their tasks were complete, because their hearts are to serve, But Yahushua told them to turn back around. He said to them, "No, you will not be going back. You're coming home. Your work is done." As we all watched, the windows of heaven opened, and we could all see for a brief moment into the heaven and its glories as he took them home for eternity. "Now, there is no time. Turn around." We all turned around toward the earth, and it was burning, and it was dark, and it was so demonic. People killing people everywhere. Complete horror. He spoke, "I am the Lord of the harvest. We have more work to do. Are you with me?" We all turned back around, all immovable and steadfast, eyes fixed on him. "Behold my glory." And a blanket came down. The glory of God, like an iridescent bluish veil over the entire body, and it merged the body of the bride into one spirit. His spirit. We were suddenly, completely, and instantly transformed from the top of our heads to our feet, glowing with his brightness. And as the words say, we shall be like him. It's time. Help me to save them. Help me to bring them home. Praise God. He made me to know instantly that we only had a very, very brief window of time, as we know it, to complete the harvest, after we are transformed, before he brought us home as well. Please go to Yahushua directly with this vision and allow him to instruct you personally. You will receive your counsel, and he will personally impart to you all that you need. This is his promise. Hallelujah to the Lord of the harvest, the Almighty King, Redeemer of the world. My cat has been doing this on and off for the past all of June. So I think it knows that something's coming.
Okay, I'm going to stop it there. Anyway, I believe he finished the whole thing. There's just a little bit left, maybe a minute or two. Anyway, this, I told you, it's called Vision of the Transformation of the Bride. Well, I didn't notice that underneath it, he had put this up on June. Here, I can take this down now. June 25th, 2017. Okay, that's how we got the date, 2017. So she must have gotten this around that time, and he found it on her blog spot. But isn't that amazing? That's why I was thinking when he said all ages, all walks of life, and I'm thinking, aren't we all supposed to be around like 30 or so? And probably after that blanket dropped over us, he talked about that iridescent blanket, that's probably when we got our glorified bodies and turned all the same age, close. How could there be children? The children, he's probably talking like the ones who are past the age of accountability, who have chosen Jesus and tried to live right according to the way they understood it for their age, and they got taken as part of the bride. Can you imagine? And then, just to think about it, message has been out since, well, I got my word from the Lord in 2016. And when he told me that he said there were three harvests, the barley harvest, which is the bride, and some others, he told me later. And of course, the children and the innocents. I'm not sure if he mentioned that in that dream or not, message. It might have been that later message. But anyway, it's all the pieces have come together from the body of Christ, which is why nobody who receives dreams, messages, or visions should exclude what other people are hearing and getting. We need to take it all in and put all the pieces together, not just our own pieces, because now I have a fuller picture of it all. And had I been too prideful to think, well, you know, she might have got that, but I didn't get that. I just wanted to share this lovely vision. This is a vision, not a dream or a message. It's a vision. And notice when he said the small group that gets taken right away into heaven were the homeless, downtrodden, probably had nobody in their life. So they probably had nobody to come back to try to witness, you know, to, because, but I have a large bunch of people to speak to, you know, so I want to come back and help Jesus harvest them. So I pray that you do too, and I pray that we all be found worthy to escape all these things that are to come to pass and to stand before the Son of Man in this group called the Bride of Christ. Be ready. Be ready so you can go to, and I think everybody knows by now, if you've been on my channel anytime at all, you must be found holy, for nothing unholy will enter the kingdom of God. And he's not going to accept an unholy bride, but this some others that he told me about later that would go with the bride. Since it sounds like in this vision, we don't actually go to heaven. We go to Mount Zion, or I don't know. We go outside of time to somewhere, but near heaven, clearly, because we looked up and saw the windows to heaven open, and those people got to go. Jesus took them on into heaven. So, you know, we'll just take it into consideration. Don't overthink it. And I have to sign in. Really have to sign in to give it a thumbs up. So I'm going to end this video now and say I plead the blood of Jesus over this video and over each and every one of us and our devices and our internet connections. I pray you all have a blessed day in the Lord, and I'll talk to you again soon as the Lord leads.